find out from the friend zone, we bring out one of our friends from here at Fox onto the show. Joining us tonight is Sean Hannity, who needs no further introduction except to say he knew our former boss, Roger Ailes, really well for decades, and we wanted to talk to him about that tonight. Sean, how would you sum up a guy as big as Roger?
He can't. He thought, there's only been three people maybe in my life that I met that have this deeper dimension in terms of the thought process. I'd often sit with him, and anytime I'd have a meeting, I don't care if it was on the phone or in his office, I'd always take a pad and a paper because I knew I was going to get four or five great ideas that would make me seem really much smarter than I am. But he saw things differently. He'd be able to cut to the chase, get rid of all the clutter. And look, Tucker, I wouldn't be on with you tonight. I was a young local radio host in Atlanta with very little TV experience, took a big risk, gave me a shot. Here I am, and he believed in me. And he did that for so many other people. As I said in my statement today, I think he would see things in people that they didn't know existed in themselves. And I can tell you from my own personal experience, that was the case. I never thought I could do this. And one other thing that he did, Tucker, which is, I think, pretty amazing, I was so bad. All you need to do is Google Hannity and Combs first show. It's humiliating. You want to bring me down to earth any day? I cringe when I see it, but he stuck with me, and I'm honored that he did, and he changed my life so much for the better and so many others.
He did that with people. He did stick with them. What did he tell you when he first hired you?
Well, I can remember one. It's a great question. I remember one meeting just before we went on the air. He warned everybody, look, you're probably going to have technical glitches. Something's going to happen. But just stay calm. I remember he told everybody, smile, have a good time. It doesn't have to be perfect on day one. This is long ball. We want to change the media landscape in the country. And he emphasized fair and balance. He wanted both sides. And then he pointed to me and Alan in the room and he said, except for you two, you can do whatever the hell you guys want.
That's and what you said. Did, I noticed.
That was, and he meant it. He left, he just let us do our thing. And, you know, one other great thing, you know, we always work in a ratings pressure world. He never once called me and said, great ratings. Never once called me and said, hey, what's wrong with your ratings either. And he knew there was an ebb and flow to the news cycle, ups and downs. That has kept me very centered. Basically, you build it and they're come. Every night, you do a great show. That's why people are watching you. I try to do the same thing. Every night, you do a good show. You work hard for your audience. You earn their viewership every night.
That's really wise. So he saw the big picture. He was a tough guy, too. Not easily pushed around.
Listen, I'm a better fighter today because I learned from him. You know, when I first started, maybe I remember there'd be certain people that would start working at the Fox News Channel. They get their first negative article written about them. I go Google my name. It's going to come up. Hannity's evil. Hannity's Satan. Hannity's this. And then I'd say, once you read it, you're going to feel so much better. And so many people have done that and followed that advice. It used to bother me. Maybe I can't even remember when. I don't care, Tucker. I don't care what people tweet, what people write, what people say. And I actually enjoy the combative back and forth in life.
For our viewers who are wondering if you're being sincere, I work with you and I can say he's not joking.
When I'm tweeting or in one of my little Twitter wars, I'm smiling. Everyone thinks it's, wow. They're like, Twitter fight. I'm like, yeah, let's get in there. I don't know. I believe in fighting for what we believe in. Now we have to fight as irredeemable deplorables for those that want to destroy the president. That's a fight I will engage in till my last breath because they're trying to undermine an election.
Sean Hannity, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks a lot, Sean.
I don't ever want to be in the enemy zone. All right, thanks, Tucker.
No, you'll never be. We'll be right
back.
Thank
you.